Mama used to say to me, above all, let God be first in your life. God is a great.
You are not alone. The Bible said in Ephesians 4:30, you are sealed with the Holy Spirit. That seal proclaim, touch not my anointed, do my prophet no harm. Therefore, who is a Christian? An embodiment of the Godhead. The Father is inside. The Son is inside. The Holy Ghost is inside. Touch and die. Dangerous naked wire.
As we worship you today, let it rain.
Hungry of fornication, hungry of theft, hungry of murder, hungry of jealousy, hungry of, oh my God, all kinds of hunger. We're not setting to play. Moses gave us food. Child, God said, but I never planned that you should eat. You eat me. So you can see why Jesus is talking about any man that does not eat of my flesh and drink of my blood has no life. What will happen is that I will give you food. That will come down from heaven. The food your fathers and your father's fathers have not known and will not know. And God release man. And they gather manna. That manna was to be enough.
Moses told God, God said, go to the rock, get water. Go to that rock, he'll give you water.
Oh, this God,
God is not just a mere religion where you just manage to come and manage to go. Yeah, you just come to service, it's time to stand up. Sometimes you're very, very reluctant to stand up. In spite of what the conductor will say and everything, you are still sitting down. It's not normal. Something is wrong. You have not been able to connect.
No.
And the Bible said, come with me to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians. Are you there? Not 1 Corinthians, sorry, 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians. Woo! Glory be to God. I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord. Before the 2 Corinthians, let's take the 1 Corinthians I wanted to call before. 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Are you there? Huh? First Corinthians chapter 10 verses 3 and 4. And did all eat the same spiritual meat? Spiritual meat. The manna was spiritual, it wasn't physical. Let's go. Verse 4. And did all drink the same spiritual drink? For they drank of the spiritual rock. That rock that followed them. And that rock was Christ. Have you seen it? It wasn't the plan of God to give them water. It wasn't the plan of God to give them food. But because of their loneliness, because of their selfishness, because of their nature, their flesh was very active. They never wanted to submit because of their pride. They started to hunger for food, physical food, which is not a plan of God. God said, why are you doing this to me? I am more than enough for you. I am the all-sufficient God. They failed. In our own time, should we fail? The same Emmanuel said, now I am dwelling. God with us. I have come to stay. The New Testament puts it this way. The Bible said that Jesus Christ has raised us to sit with him in heavenly places. Think Ephesians 2:6, is it also? Sylvester, can you read me Ephesians 2:6 there? What did he say?
And
yes,
and had raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Did you hear that? Do you see yourself physically staying here? You're supposed to be in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. You are not ordinary. You are a spirit person like your brother, the firstborn, who is Jesus Christ. He is a spirit person. He is God. He is man. He is here connecting what is up there. He is God. He is the Son of God. And behold, God gave you that capacity, that enablement. He conferred on you power to become Son of God. As many us receive him. To them he gave power to become sons of God. Not ordinary people. He gave you power that makes you not to be ordinary, but to be extraordinary. Power to make you not to be natural. It will make you as supernatural. Something different. But you keep yourself down, behaving like ordinary children. That is not the plan of God. That's not the plan of God. Emmanuel, God with us. You don't need to be afraid. If God be for us, who can be against us? That's what all those statements mean. They are not just there for fancy. If God be for us, Emmanuel, God with us, in the wilderness, a pillar of cloud in the day, as far as the Lord of hosts, the King of kings, the El Shaddai, I am that I am, is standing in the midst of Israel. No animal, no tiger, no lion, no bear, no human, no maruda can come near. That's what he made you to be. God with us. Not even that is outside, is inside. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And yet we fear to go to the village. We fear to help people, because if I give them that money, they will use it against me. Congratulations. Look at it. Missionaries. Christian. What kind of Christian is that? He is to supply. Paul puts it this way. He will supply all my needs. Not from scarcity, but from the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. Change your mindset. Christianity is not just a mere religion. Just identify. Belong to one church. Belong to one fellowship. It's more than that. It's life to be lived. Man, God with us. He will supply. In the night, a pillar of cloud. Darkness shall not come near. The light shineth in darkness, and darkness could not comprehend it. He was there. Egyptians could not attack Israel by night because the pillar moved and stayed between Egypt and Israel. Israel has light. Egypt has darkness. And without darkness, they can make no move. They wouldn't even know their direction. They will be forced to sleep. God has given you every protection you needed in this life. The angels of the Lord encamp around the righteous. That's within the physical days. In the spiritual day, Jesus said, I have given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Power over all the powers of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. When we talk, it's a mere statement. It's a phraseology. It's a terminology. We just waste every day of our lives. Many people are suffering because you are not manifesting. You're supposed to manifest and help somebody. Some people are sick because I'm not manifesting at the level I'm supposed to manifest. To heal them and free them. Lose them and let them go. In
just see her sitting tight, playing religion. As far as I attend Sunday service, it's okay. That is enough. God understand. I'm very busy. Congratulations. I've never seen. No, I don't want to make that statement. But what I want to let you understand is that you are not making use of the capacity, the enablement invested in you by God. You are not making use of it. You have not even made use of it. The thing is lying down there 100%, not used. Because we do act from morning till evening. We never remember Jesus. We will only remember him when something we are holding, one to four, or fell down. Jesus! Pick it. That's the only time you remember Jesus. For those of the Old Testament, there was an instruction from God. Meditate upon the word of God day and night. When you are seated, when you are lying down, write it even on your doorpost. Write it on your hand and tie it on your arm so that when you turn, remember the word of God. And this word is Christ. That's it. No consciousness you are a Christian. Nothing. That's why the devil is gaining an upper hand. It seems God is no more working. People will be praying and praying. Nothing is happening because you never connected. If you don't connect to a TV, no matter what you gaze and gaze from the TV, you won't see anything. Who's he? You need to connect. You don't have to collect. Tired of all this kind of Christianity. And again, when you go see, thank God. Therefore, what have you achieved? Do the spirits know you in the spirit world? Paul, I know. Eh? Jesus, I know. Who are you? We have to stop this kind of Christianity. Christianity is not a showman business. It's a serious business. It's life to live. Life to live, life to enjoy. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there are pleasures forever. Life to live, life to enjoy. But you have made Christianity a burden on Sunday, sir. I don't know. Some of you even are praying, let there be rain on Sunday morning. So you can use that as an excuse. You know, the thing rain.
Watch home video.
Eh?
Watch home video.
Eh?
Watch home video.
Uh-huh. Because of that, you think you are covered. You're not covered. Miri Maramo, Evene So Jesu. Awo Charamo, Evene So Jesus. Miri Maramo. You see, I'm woman, Miri Maram, my American.
I wasn't offended.
The wage into my mother, stopped church because the rain was falling. Even if the umbrella spoil, you will go and find this cocoyam. Cocoyam this thing and put it and start going to church. Our own. You know, the place we are flooded. If it is flooded, you are wearing your shoe. Why not enter it? Shoe will protect you. No, we remove the shoe. It's costly. Put your leg. Your leg that is more costly than the shoe. Have you ever seen a white man remove his shoe? Even climbing. One man will never remove his shoe. He put, because the shoe is meant to protect your leg. What a reverse. The hour has come, brethren. Something needs to be done.
If not, we'll be suffering in the midst of plenty. How can we be called Christians? Live the life we are not living. Manifest and do things that a Christian is supposed to do. We are not doing. No, there must be a change, a serious change, a serious change, change for the best. You will see things will begin to happen. It's very difficult people to have testimony these days. Because nothing is happening. it is, when something happened, you testify. When something didn't happen, how would you testify? It's very difficult. People fear things that will help them. So today, please, when you are leaving this place, make up your mind. Like Joshua said, choose between this day whom you will serve. Whether the gods of your father over the river, or you will serve the Lord. Whether you will serve the Lord. For me and my family, we will serve the Lord. I want signs and wonders begin to happen in your house without anybody praying for you. I want miracles begin to happen in your family. God will be particular about you. In the first service, I was telling them about Paul. I tell them about what Paul said. The angel of the Lord God, of whom I am and of whom I serve. Of whom I am. He identified me as his own. Therefore, the angel said, Paul is an asset of God. Nothing will happen to you, Paul. And because of you, no soul, whether the soul knows how to swim or not, will be lost. No soul. No soul. And no soul lost. Only the sheep. Ready? Tomorrow, we are beginning what I call an emergency, a spiritual emergency. But let me put it this way, a spiritual state of emergency. That's why I say it's compulsory, it's not compulsory. Because God has given a signal. Something is about to happen. That is so. So you better get prepared. Don't like the Jews that are not prepared. They only prepare for 3 days. They want to see God. God says, let them sanctify themselves. Let them wash their dress. So that they can hear me. If they were sensible, they would have been washing their dress every day. So that they will continue to hear God. But they only wash that day and forget it. Get connected. Eat your lunch. Eat your breakfast. But in the night, eat no food. And pray sincerely. Not prayer of fear. Because you have nothing to fear. We have 365. Don't be afraid in the Bible. Which means one each day. God tells you, you have no right, you have no audacity to be afraid of a man, to be afraid of juju, to be afraid of witches. You are even more dangerous than they are. But because you don't want to become whom you are, whom you're supposed to be. He made his angels ministering spirit. He made his minister flame of fire. If there is anything a witch is afraid of, he's afraid of fire. Now instead of witch to be afraid, you who is fire is being afraid of witch.
tell your neighbor it's an error. Let's pray. Talk to God. I don't want to tell you what to talk about. Business is not moving. Just because you are not connected. When you're connected, God will bring customers for you. I'm reading without understanding. It's because you are not connected. When you're connected, you'll be given the spirit of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. I'm sick. You are not connected. Connect. That sickness will run away from you. As you finish this prayer, you will not see it again. Enough is enough. What kind of nonsense is this? Is God a joker? He's not a joker. Whosoever joins in this fasting and prayer, that is single, shall never, ever, if you do it according to instruction, you have not tested pregnancy, get ready for your sudden pregnancy. If you have no job, get ready. It's a month of appointments. Get ready for your appointment. Keep your watch, keep your phone open. Text messages and letters. Radio announcements. Did you hear what I'm talking about? That's why it's a month of divine what? Appointment. Father, we thank you. Take all the glory. Take all the praises. Show mercy. Release grace. In Jesus' name we pray.